Hi guys, this is Vaish from Vaish IAS. We are going to continue the Geography NCERT series, class 10th, chapter 2 today. We have already done all the classes from class 6, 7, 8, 9. So a lot of videos are there in our channel. Please watch it. If you are a true aspirant, a serious aspirant for UPSC 2018, you cannot miss the NCERTs at any cost. It's okay if you could not start the NCERTs even now, because my videos, everything will be like, I think if class 6th means you have to spend maximum 2 hours for the all videos, like every class will have 2 to 3 hours of video only. So maybe in 15-16 hours you can complete the entire class 6 to 12th NCERTs. Okay, as of now we have reached class 10th, but I assure you, like, I'll be completing Geography NCERT till class 12, and based on the response only I'll be creating it for History, Polity and other subjects, because I have the books available. I just need to, anyway I'm reading through it, I can simply make videos and upload, but you people have to give me the response for it. Okay, so that's why I'm always telling you, give me comments or give me suggestions so that we can proceed on it. And MCQs, please buy from the Facebook page, which is mentioned here, facebook.com/vaishias. There every MCQ, every subject, it's there. UPSC standard questions, current affairs are dealt with in detail, NCERTs are dealt with in detail, standard books, popular YouTube videos, from everywhere I have taken content and then framed questions. Okay, so you'll not miss anything. Okay, Hindu, PIB, everything is covered. Even now, economic survey and India ebook, I am making new PDFs, so for that also MCQs will be available, 100 MCQs, and it's all available at very cheap rates. Along with that, you will get all my revision charts also for free related to that subject whichever you're buying. So enjoy your learning from Vaish IAS. Now we'll proceed to class 10, chapter 2. PDFs available in NCERT website, please download. If you don't find the link, just ask me, I'll tell you where you can get it. So this chapter is about forest and wild resources. Not a very big chapter and not too much important. Lot of animal names will be there, lot of plant names will be there, but you know, whatever is there in the current affairs is what UPSC asks. So here in first line you will see something like the Lepcha fox folk song. Okay, so usually UPSC has this habit of asking folk names, tribe names and all those things which have been there in the news, and they'll give you match the following questions. So here, because in NCERT it is mentioned, you should remember, like, Lepcha folk song is something which is there in the northern part of West Bengal, so you can tell it is almost near the Sikkim border also. So Sikkim, I think Lepcha tribe was in news 1 year back. So Lepcha, you should relate like West Bengal and Sikkim. Anything other than this in the choice, you should not mark it as correct. Now here animals and plants, forest, everything play a key role in ecological system. That's the crux of this paragraph, so I'm not going into detail on that. Then biodiversity. Okay, we have the Biodiversity Act also, 2002. Try to remember all the important act: Forest Act, Air Act, Water Act. Then there is this Wildlife Protection Act, 1972. Then there is one Environment Act, 1986. So just 6 or 7 act is there. Just order it in chronological order. Years automatically you will get by heart, like which year what came. Okay. And so immensely rich in wildlife and cultivated species, diverse in form and function, but closely integrated in a system through multiple network of interdependencies. So variety of things, whether it be plant or wildlife, but they are in closely staying in a same community by interdependent or interrelating with each other. That is biodiversity. Okay. Flora and fauna in India. India is one of the richest countries in terms of biodiversity. You know that. It's called one of the, I think, mega biodiverse nations. Out of the 12 top countries, it is there. It is there in the list. Then numbers keeps on increasing, decreasing. And you know, a lot of schemes are there related to animals also. A lot of acts are there. Wildlife schedules are there. Wildlife Protection Act has Schedule 1 to 4, which protects the animals. Schedule 5, which is having the vermin animals. And Schedule 6 is having the plant species. So it has a lot of rules within India, and also it follows a lot of international guidelines. So protection is ensured in India. So 81,000 species of fauna, 47,000 species of flora, 15,000 flowering plants. Okay, just giving the range of things available in India. And here there are a lot of plant names, not much important actually. They are mentioning cheetah, pink-headed duck, mountain quail, forest spotted owlet. These are all critical. Okay, but I don't want you to depend on this thing. If you have not gone to the IUCN website till now, then you are not a really serious aspirant, I would say. There is IUCN website where the red list is there. Any animal you want to know, like suppose you want to know about a pygmy hog, just Google like pygmy hog IUCN list. Immediately that red color page will come, which has the red list. Okay, and it will tell you clearly what category it is right now. Okay, it is updated all the time. and you will know. So whenever you see some animal in the current affairs, make open an Excel sheet, take a column with the animal name, and then against it write the IUCN status. So maximum 20-25 things only you will get in 1 year. Okay, 25 or maximum 30 animals, animals, birds, plants, everything included, you will get it. Make a list of that, and then before the prelims just go through it. That's all. Don't depend on coaching materials. Don't tell like, okay, they did not teach me this, they did not teach me that. If you are following Hindu and if you are following current affairs, then your preparation for any subject, any topic in UPSC is done parallelly. Okay, it's up to you, like whether you want to clear it or not. Okay, now larger animals, smaller animals is not important. Vanishing forest, you know, the deforestation and all, then forest fire, all these things will happen. And these are just statistics based in the state of forest report. Report I told you, every 2 years it comes, that forest report. For Indian Forest Service aspirants, you should definitely read that. Okay, 2015 report I had seen, a lot of statistics were there, like which state has the maximum forest cover and which has the least, which union territory has it. Well, all those things. 2017 report, I don't know whether it has come or not. If it has come, then that is the latest one, you should go through that. IUCN, as I told, so based on IUCN we can classify as follows. Okay, the normal species, the endangered species, vulnerable species. This one is all not the proper namings. You should go and see the IUCN website. You will get that in the topmost section of the page itself. Like they tell the 6-7 categories they have, like extinct is there, extinct in the wild is there, vulnerable, then there is near threatened, there is something like that. Here it is all different basic names. Just for NCERT purpose they have taken basic names. And animal names also, I'm not reading it out. There are a lot of names given, but this may not be the current status. So I don't want you to by heart these things. Just know like there are a lot of levels, and there are animals from India also, outside India also, which comes in all these categories. Okay, there are some things which are not at all like for concern, like least concerned animal all is there in the list. Meaning we don't need to do any much protection. It is already there in abundant number and it is flourishing throughout the world. Okay, I think flamingo bird is something which is least concerned. Just confirm that. Asiatic cheetah, fastest animal. So these again a lot of stories. This chapter doesn't have much thing, that's why I'm scrolling down. Only UPSC related studies we are doing from NCERT. Okay, our goal is not to complete NCERT and tell everybody like I completed NCERT. Our goal is to extract only the things which is needed for UPSC. Okay, Narmada Sagar project in Madhya Pradesh. So they're telling again clearing forest and all is done. So human intervention is destroying forest, that is the crux. Baksa Tiger Reserve is in West Bengal. Okay. Actually, this I yesterday noticed some tribe name called Baksa, and I think it is not in West Bengal. Okay, so don't confuse yourself. The tiger reserve is in West Bengal, but Baksa tribes is somewhere else. Try to find out that. Many foresters and environmentalists hold the view that greatest degrading factors behind the depletion of forest resources are grazing and fuel wood collection. Okay, so if I can hold the view that the greatest degrading factors behind the depletion of forest are grazing and fuel wood collection. Though there may be some substances in their argument, yet the fact remains that substantial part of fuel fodder demand is met by lopping rather than by felling entire trees. So they are telling that those many people argue like grazing and collecting the forest fuel wood and all is bad, but it is not the fact. Okay, because that is not causing that much damage compared to the development project, construction of dams and all those things. These are all people, tribal people do, and it is okay. It's not too good, but it is okay compared to rapid expanding industrial economy and all those things. Himalayan ewe in trouble, again some article about a chemical compound called taxol is extracted from the bark, needles, twigs, roots of this tree. Okay. This name I don't think you have to remember. A tree name is there, Himalayan yew. Okay, might be an old news article. Again some pictures of people collecting plants and firewood. Habitat destruction, hunting, poaching, over exploitation, these are good points. Make a note. Environmental pollution, poisoning and forest fires are factors which have led to the decline in the Indian biodiversity. Other important causes of environmental destruction are unequal access, inequitable consumption of resources, and differential sharing of responsibility for environmental well-being. Overpopulation is in third world countries often called as a cause of environmental degradation. So we got lot of points actually. If you elaborate each of these things easily, you can write a 10 marker question also. Okay, the factors for degradation of environment. So again, comparison not required. Half of India's natural resources are gone, 1/3 of its wetland drained out. So they're again telling degradation rate, like this much gone. Okay. So degradation of forest and wildlife is not just a biological issue. The biological loss is strongly correlated with the loss of cultural diversity. Such losses have increasingly marginalized and impoverished many indigenous and other forest dependent communities. So biological loss and also cultural loss, because the tribes and people are getting affected and they depend on it for medicine, culture, spirituality, everything. Okay, within the poor, women are affected more than men. Okay, because many societies, women bear the major responsibility of collection of fuel, fodder, water and all those things. So women are affected more because else they have to go far, like lot of kilometers just for water and all. In Africa and all, still it happens. Okay, people are walking kilometers and kilometers with small cans just to carry water. So imagine, like, the globe and the world is moving towards development, and then people don't have even water to drink. So that's a very serious problem. So it's responsibility of the government and bureaucracy to make sure that everybody is out of these kind of troubles. Okay, at least in India, it's our responsibility, whoever is preparing for the exam, our responsibility to get into the service and fix things whichever is there in remote tribal areas and in such kind of situations. Okay, try to do good things and such things. So for conservation of forest and wildlife in India, conservation in the background of rapid decline in wildlife population and forestry has become essential. Conservation preserves the ecological diversity. Then agriculture, we are still dependent on traditional crop varieties. Fisheries too are heavily dependent on the maintenance of aquatic biodiversity. So entire economy is also dependent. So we are seeing ecological, biological, cultural, economical, everywhere biodiversity conservation is very much important. So it's very basic point. We don't have much things to take away from here. These kind of stories, anyone who is preparing for UPSC for at least 2-3 months, they can easily write it up. So nothing extra from NCERT. Pictures, one horned rhino, Kaziranga National Park. Gharial, last year 2017 question, where it was found, like it is in Chambal, okay, in Madhya Pradesh. Asiatic lion, you know, gir forest is there. That also 2017 they asked, like it is shifted to Palampur Reserve in Madhya Pradesh. Black buck, great Indian bustard, these are all in news. Try to find out the IUCN status of it. Project Tiger. Tiger is one of the key wildlife species in the faunal web. In 1973, the authorities realized that the tiger population had dwindled to 1827 from an estimated 55,000. So see the drastic reduction, okay. That is why we are trying to save the tiger. It is also declared the national animal. National animal is not simply declared just like that, okay. It is declared so that it is getting protected. Most states also do that. Whichever is declining, they will make it as a state animal so that at least people respect it and then stops killing it or hunting it. 1970 year is also important, because 1972 I told you Wildlife Protection Act. So 1973 they did the Project Tiger. So 1970s, that time they are doing good things, okay, for the animal protection at least. I don't know about humans at that time, but at least for animals they have been doing good things. The trade of tiger skins and use of their bones in traditional medicine, especially in the Asian countries, left the tiger population on the verge of extinction. So you know, in the Southeastern nation and all, they used to trade for medicinal purpose. Then tiger tooth, tiger claws, tiger skin, all these things were being traded. That is why it reduced to a drastic reduction, like 55,000 to 1827. Project Tiger, one of the well-publicized wildlife campaign in the world, was launched in 1973. Initially, it showed success as tiger population went up. Okay, last year, 2017, again one question, M Stripes is related to what? So M Stripes is actually a mobile app for the monitoring or the surveying of tigers. So 2017, if you see, three questions have already come from this page only, okay. They have not given answers directly, but when you see these things, obviously you will learn things related to it, right? That's what a UPSC aspirant should do, not like mug up things which you get as material. Whatever you learn in news, whatever you see in different places, you should read something in Wikipedia, at least the first paragraph about each of the things. That is how you proceed. So related things you will learn, okay. Even MCQs, I tell you, like 100 MCQs you attempt, it's like 100 topics you learn, okay. And it's not 100 topics, if there are 4 options for each question, it's like 400 topics you are learning. It's not like get the correct answer and ignore the other 3. You should have a clear understanding of all the 4 options of every MCQ you do in mock test. Okay. Wildlife Act of 1980 and 86, lot of acts are mentioned, not required. This chapter, I don't think we have anything much to take away, but I am telling you a lot of extra things. Gharial, again, these kind of news item schemes, that is why Chambal was asked. This is one important page. You need to know what is reserved forest, what is protected forest, and what is unclassed forest. Okay. Reserved forest, that is more than half of the total forest land has been declared reserved forest. Reserved forests are regarded as the most valuable as far as the conservation of forest and wildlife resources are concerned. So reserved forest is something which has to be mostly protected because of the most valuable resources. Now protected forest is like one third. This was one half, this is one third. okay, and is declared by the Forest Department. This forest land protected from any further depletion, okay. So something which is getting depleted and any further depletion has to be prevented, that is protected forest. Now unclassed forest is something like forest and wasteland belonging to both government and private, okay, and communities. So it's owned by multiple people and it is forest and wasteland both, okay, that is unclassed forest. So three definitions you know now. Reserved and protected areas are also referred to as permanent forest estates, okay. Permanent forest estates, it's not owned by these communities or not. So for the purpose of producing timber and other forest produce and for protective reasons. Madhya Pradesh has the largest area under permanent forest. This will keep on changing. See the latest report, latest news for correct thing. Jammu and Kashmir, Andhra, Uttarakhand, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, West Bengal, Maharashtra have large percentage of reserved forest in its total forest area. Whereas Bihar, Haryana, Punjab, Himachal Pradesh, Orissa, Rajasthan have bulk of it under protected forest. So it's like just telling like this many states have reserved, this many states are protected. We don't need that much statistical information. Community and conservation. Conservation strategies are not new in our country. We often ignore that in India. Forests are also home to some of the traditional communities. In some areas of India, local communities are struggling to conserve these habitats along with the government officials, recognizing that only this will secure their own long-term livelihood. So again, conserving thing. Sariska Tiger Reserve is in Rajasthan, you should know. In many areas, villages themselves are protecting habitats and explicitly rejecting government involvement. The inhabitants of five villages in Alwar district of Rajasthan have declared 1,200 hectares of forest as Bhairodev Dakav Sonchri, declaring their own set of rules. Okay, so Rajasthan, they are doing their own initiative. So this is just a term. Again, current affairs, if it is there only, then you need to know. Sacred groves is an important thing. Mock test, I see a lot of questions like what are sacred groves. So it's actually snakes or something, natural forces will be worshipped, okay. In most of the southern states it's common, it's there in across India also, and it has different names in different states, okay. So that actually in the Wikipedia page they have a table, try to see that. I am not able to recall, there is something like Kavu, Kadu and all, they call it has such terms in their regional naming. So at least 4 or 5 South Indian state names, what is the corresponding sacred grove, try to get the names from Wikipedia. It will be important if a massive following question comes, at least that 2 marker you won't miss it. Nothing big or rocket science, it is there, it is just a biotting of 4 or 5 names, okay. It's very simple names also, okay. And again, these are good examples of old movements where humans, like communities involved other than the government, the people took initiative. Chipko movement in Himalayas has not only successfully resisted the deforestation in several areas, but has also shown that community afforestation with indigenous species can be enormously successful. Attempts to revive the traditional conservation methods or developing new methods of ecological farming are now widespread. Farmers and citizen group like, again farmers and citizen group, okay, Beech Bachao Andolan in Tehri and Navdhania have shown that adequate levels of diversified crop production without the use of synthetic chemicals are possible and economically viable. So people are taking initiative and doing these kind of things. SIPCO movement, Beech Bachao Andolan, Navdhania, okay. In India, joint forest management program furnishes a good example of involving local communities. Again, joint forest, so again people are involving. Program has been informal existence since 1988. Then not much important, I think the chapter should be done by this because they are concluding here, okay. So this is basic information about the forest cover and the animals. We'll see basic MCQs. Which of these statements is not a valid reason for the depletion of flora and fauna? So agricultural expansion, it'll again destroy flora fauna. Large scale development project also will destroy. Grazing and fuel wood, we saw like in this text, like people think it is wrong but it is okay. So that is the correct answer. Which of the following conservation strategies do not directly involve community? So joint, we have Beech Bachao, Chipko. Demarcation of wildlife, and this actually government is doing, so people don't have the direct role. And this one I don't want you to answer, because this one try to find out at least these 5 names. Go to IUCN right now, black buck IUCN, Asiatic elephant IUCN, just Google it. You will get what status it is, okay. Then write down it in an Excel sheet before prelim, just revise it again. Now these 3 definitions we have seen in this chapter, so just match it. Reserved forest are the second one, forest are regarded as most valuable, okay, as far as the forest conservation and wildlife resources concerned. Protected forest is something like protected from any further depletion. And unclassed forest is like this government and private individuals. Okay, so reserved, protected, unclassed, massive following. So we have done with chapter 2 of class 10. I'll come up with the next video soon. Till then, thank you and have a nice day.